Canyonlands National Park. Remote. Vast. Spectacular. Canyonlands National Park. West of the Colorado Plateau, the park is located in the southeastern part of Utah, an area rich in canyons. At the confluence of the Colorado and Green Rivers, a mesa rises from sheer sandstone cliffs 1,000 feet into the air over the surrounding Canyonlands panorama, the Island in the Sky, a 43-square-mile wilderness mesa. Rugged, harsh, primitive. A maze of unexplored canyons. A winding labyrinth of hazardous chasms. One of the most inaccessible regions in the United States. Cross the Colorado River from the maze, and you're in the Needles. Wilderness. Massive spires of rust and coral standing in twisted formation. Solid rock patterned with red and white bands, which were 270 million years in the making. Search the landforms of Needles, and you'll come across ancient Indian ruins and these prehistoric petroglyphs and pictographs. Needles is also the site of the Cave Spring Trail. Here is where cowboys used to herd their cattle. Traces of what had been their camps are found here, in this cave. Cowboys no longer come to the cave to get water, but birds do. Nevertheless, this is cowboy country. Cowboys still tend cattle and acreage skirting the park. Just outside the park is Robber's Roost, where the infamous Wild Bunch hid out. The Roost's most celebrated outlaws are Butch Cassidy and the Sundance Kid. Best known as they were portrayed in a classic Hollywood Western. Those runaway outlaws have long since fled. But the bighorn sheep are still here, though very wary. Their skittishness is understandable. Before park protection, they'd been hunted almost to extinction. It's simply amazing, their ability to skitter on the narrowest of ledges at the highest of heights. While hiking, should you stumble on remote Horseshoe Canyon, you'll encounter a great gallery of prehistoric rock art, one of the most significant in North America. Sinister, faceless, bigger than life figures hovering over you. Taller than humans, there are those who believe that they are pictures of one-time visitors from outer space. More likely, ritual rock art creations of nomadic archaic people who lived in these canyons several thousand years ago. Where the two rivers collide, the Colorado and the Green, the rivers that carved these canyons, they're transformed into raging whitewater. Rafters need permits to run the course, with a skilled river runner in charge. Here, the waters plunge 30 feet in just 1 mile. A Jeep road over Elephant Hill is the most challenging trailway in the park. You need a four-wheel drive vehicle to climb it. Here, you'll see plenty of tricked-out cars chugging noisily up this rock-strewn slope. A sportier and increasingly popular way to negotiate these tortuous dirt roads is mountain biking. Stand on a park overlook and gasp at the spectacle before you. Canyon after canyon reaching to the horizon. This isn't simply the Wild West. It's America at its wildest.